Since the early 1900s, the numbers of bearded vultures have dropped dramatically across Europe. But since 1986, our partners and we, the Vulture Conservation Foundation, have been restoring this population by releasing captive-bred bearded vultures on different sites in Europe. This reintroduction has led to a huge success. The numbers have risen enormously, and we now have the demographically stable population across the Alps. But we are still releasing young bearded vultures, like on this site in Melzeefrut in Switzerland, where our partners, the Stiftung Paul Bartgeier, has just released two bearded vultures on that cliff up there for a very specific reason.
So we are here releasing two new bearded vultures back there in the release cave. They're here for 1 week now, and they're very special. Both of them will bring new genetic diversity into the alpine population. Actually, these two have like 50 and 25% Pyrenean blood in them from birds which are not yet represented in the alpine bearded vulture population. This is necessary as our birds, and what we already heard, that demographically the population is growing, but on the genetic diversity side, the things look a bit different. We do have around 40 birds which started the population back in the captivity, but actually the more than 50% of the genetic information of the birds living in the Alps go back to only six different birds. So that leads to inbreeding, so the mating of relatives, and then to inbreeding depression, especially in the long term. This might not be the big issue now, but in 10, 20, 40 years, it might become an issue. That's why we are releasing new birds from new origin to boost the genetic diversity. So we are releasing the bearded vultures by the hacking method. The hacking method is that we use captive bred birds, and before they even can fly, we put them in their actual natural habitat, like we are here seeing in the background. In this way, they get used to the environment, they get used to the other habitants of the mountains, like the other birds, like ibex, like chamois. And also very important, they can actually make their first flight whenever they're ready. So that means the hacking cave is not blocked, so they cannot walk out of it, but once they fly, they can leave it. And like this, they kind of see this surroundings, this area, as their home. And with the bearded vultures, 50 to 70 birds come back to breed later in the same area. Not in this niche, but in the surroundings. So that's why we use this method for the release of the bearded vulture.
When the bearded vultures are released, the birds are guarded 24/7. Here in Switzerland, the staff of the Stiftung Paul Bartgeier is living up in two small cabins up in the mountains, about 2400 meters altitude, where they spent 3 months observing and monitoring the birds and educating the general public on the behavior and the presence of these birds.
So when we put the bird in the hacking cave, we immediately start to monitor them. That's important to know their well-being, to see their development. So usually we're working in teams of 2 to 4 person. We are observing them directly through the scope. Here we also installed a webcam just next to the release cave, where sometimes in bad weather, we are able still to see the birds when there is too much fog, to see through the scope. Everything the birds do is noted down, especially the amount of food they intake, which is kind of a most important part, you know, that they're healthy and their development can go on. This is done also after the first flight, and we keep on monitoring them usually 4 to 6 weeks after they fledged, and after that the GPS tags, the rings and the bleached feathers will surface to know where the birds are going. So besides the release of the birds, education of all the people is also very important for the reintroduction of the bearded vulture. The bearded vulture was extirpated due to unknowingness and to false information of bearded vultures actually killing sheep and even stealing little babies out of the towns. So at the same time as we observe the bird, we also have an information stand where the people can visit us and we explain them about the bearded vulture, about the behavior. They can observe it themselves. So that will help that the same thing doesn't happen anymore in the future. For example, the old name for the bearded vulture in German, but also in English, is Lämmergeier. Lämmergeier means the vulture with the lamb, which is totally wrong. So that's why, especially in English, we also changed recently the name, the official name, to bearded vulture and not Lämmergeier anymore.